Live in faith.
Sunland Apple, IPTV Entertainment. Perfected Face is the best makeup artist. Candy 242-395-0125.
Today's positive quote: walk by faith, not by sight.
Yes, walk by faith and not by sight, y'all. Right? To walk by faith is to live in faith. Every day I got to believe. Every day I got to have confidence in God, right? Even if I don't see my way coming out, even if I don't see things being worked out, I know that God is able to do it because I got to live in faith. And to walk by faith, to live in faith is to have confidence, is to put my energy and my attention on things that have eternal significance. Because see, oftentimes we focus on things that don't have no eternal significance. We worry about things that have no eternal significance. We stress about things that have no eternal significance, right? Our spirit, it has eternal significance. Our soul has eternal significance, right? It's all about focusing on things that have eternal significance. So read the books, stay positive, read the scriptures, stay prayerful, right? Because you got to focus on things that have eternal significance. Let's build each other up because your spirit and your soul has eternal significance, right? So no matter what, live in faith, right? No matter what, walk by faith and not by sight, right? And as always, believe in it, pray about it, and work at it. God is superb.
I'm telling you this because even though you are children and the elders in your life have lived longer, many times adults need the faith of children. And if you hold on to this faith really tightly, someday soon, you will understand all of what I am saying to you.
Young people, I'm a priest. I sit in my office. Many young people, I don't think they understand what marriage is. Their marriages will be blessed in April. By October, they won't divorce. Some will be blessed in January. By June, they are chasing us. And when they come, you tell them, go for marriage counseling, 6 months. They say, no, it's too long. But man, look at that, these two sacraments, the priesthood and marriage. I went to the seminary for 10 years. 10. Before I was ordained the priest. Even that one is still not easy. 10. The priest you see in your parishes, nobody was ordained 5 years old. 9, 10, 11, some even 13. And you want to marry, have 6 months counseling, understand the sacrament, imbue it into your hearts, get it. Understand that whatever you be taught there, receive the word of God, not as the word of man, but as truly is the word of God. No, we don't want. And so many of us don't enter into the sacrament of marriage understanding what we are entering. We watch DSTV, TV3 or whatever, and we think that what we see on the television as marriage is marriage. No, the sacrament of marriage is greater than that. The giving of the self to each other, that a man and a woman will live together as one. It is not easy. Before you met, maybe in a school or everywhere, you had lived your lives apart from each other for years, over 20 years. So if you are going to stay together, you need grace that the two of you can stay as what? One. There will be differences in understanding, but you communicate with each other. But one of the basic things I think is affecting marriages is pride. P-R-I-D-E, pride. Not ready to humble ourselves to understand each other. Men, oh, we are the head of the family, we won't understand you. Women, oh yes, that is the issue. And I'm talking about, sure, marriages have always, there have always been divorces. But the rate at which it is happening now is dangerous. And for us, the Catholic Church, note that even when the state has granted you divorce, your family has accepted the drinks, and you think that you have broken the marriage traditionally and what? Within the civil context. Don't think that the church can be forced to annul a marriage. No, I know people who have had civil divorce, they have gone through the traditional divorce, but the church still sees them as what? Married. As we heard, once I say to you, whoever divorces his wife, unless the marriage is unlawful, and marries another commits adultery. So until we detect that there was something unlawful, there was an impediment, the marriage cannot be declared invalid. It is valid. Reason why we will say in Latin, festina lente, hasten slowly. Hasten, but slowly. Take your time. There is no giddy giddy in life, as Father Chifu will say. Take it easy. Understand. Let the Lord inspire you. Make sure you make the right choice. And nobody is perfect. But make the right choice. Take your time. Learn, go through counseling. And sometimes I blame myself. As a priest, I'm part. And sometimes to the parents. In the Catholic Church, I say always, a male can marry at the age of 16. In the canon law, 16, 1-6. A female can marry at the age of 14, 1-4. So this is all to them. All them are qualified per the canon law. But the church allows, is careful, that not all places would have people at these ages mature enough, isn't it? So the laws of the country. So if the country you are in allows 16, 14, well, if you want to take, no problem. But like a place like Ghana, whereby 16, 14, you go and tell your mother you want to marry. Hey, you don't want to sleep in the house again. You don't want to eat for 1 month. You want to stop school. You know, the laws of the country takes control. But why am I saying this? We have what we call remote counseling. Remote. And then immediate counseling. Remote counseling is that when the child has even received confirmation, like these young ones, even if it's once in a month, isn't it? They have catechesis to understand what? The sacrament of what? Marriage. So when you're on vacation, the counselors meet them, the priest will meet them, and you teach them, because many of them are coming from homes that there is divorce. I go to secondary schools, Ola, St. Rose's, Pope John's, whatever, for retreats. You'll be amazed the number of children coming to you who are from broken families, who have never seen their fathers or never seen their mothers, and they are weeping as they speak to you. So you see that it is important that the church fills in the gap by teaching them the precepts of good marriage. And sometimes some don't even want to marry because of what they have seen in the lives of their parents. And that is why, parents, please don't follow pride. If you know what some children tell us as priests, then that you are so broken. The parents are following pride. Oh no, no, Father, I will not. And you see the child, one lady, say, Father, I never thought after 19 years that my parents will divorce. Never. Never. Broken. He says, Father, I'm even scared of marriage. If my father and mother, the family I knew, and I knew this family, to go there at Christmas to church and all that. Yes. And you see that what they had discovered, it is just something trivial. Pride, communication, giving up of the self. Look at Jesus Christ. Christ is married to the church. If Christ, do you know the number of times the church has broken the heart of Christ? He still continues to be Christ. He has not divorced the church. Are we priests? Are we better than you, even the living faithful? Isn't Christ still faithful to the church? Look at the number of times you have sinned against God. He is still faithful. Look at him. He is still faithful. And your wife has done one. And you don't want to change. You are so arrogant. And you can pride yourself. Hey, you are not scared of the gift that God has given you. You think marriage is, I made a choice. It is a gift from God. So please, let us take counseling serious. And I tell you, when your children are told, come for remote counseling, allow them to go. Don't tell them, go and watch a PlayStation 5. Go and watch a movie. Let's go and eat omutuo. Let them learn about the church. Remote counseling. Immediate counseling is what you do. The 6 months, isn't it? Even that one, the Pope has, just about a month ago, said that it is too what? We should have lengthy catechesis. Because in other jurisdictions, they don't even have the 6 months. One month, they are married. So that the immediate counseling will teach you maybe how to have sex, how to do this, you know, but how to take care of your wife, take care of your husband, marriage life, as young as 16, 14, the children must begin to understand. Those who want to be priests will be priests. Those who be married couples will be better married, then we can solve the problem and pray that God himself will fill us with his grace. The last part of my homily, about the last part of the gospel. Some are incapable of marriage because they were born so. Some because they were made so by others. Some because they have renounced marriage for the kingdom of heaven. Many a time I meet Catholics asking, Father, why are you not married? Matthew chapter 19, when you go read the whole verse 3 to verse 12 again. And when they ask you questions, Anna, Romans often worry. Sure, some of ourselves have been making mistakes, breaking our vows of celibacy and all that. But God's grace will surely lead us through. And we pray, that's why you'll be praying for your priest. Because we have renounced, not that we are impotent, we are potent too, we are potent. I'm not impotent. No, it's just, you see, by the way, people do, they think, I remember when I was in Taifa, one person said, hey, Father, now who am I? Other than, so, who am I with feelings? I'm saying, eh, do I look like a tree? Do I look like a tree? I'm a human being. But you have renounced, isn't it? You have renounced marriage for the sake of the kingdom of heaven. Because in heaven, there is no what? There's no marriage. Don't think that you marry your husband again in heaven. So some of you, you'll be very happy there will be no marriage in heaven. Say, by the way you meet your husband, because you're happy you will meet your wife again in heaven as a couple. But you know, as we say,
Perfected Faces done by Candy 242-395-0125.
Tell us all as time, true as it can be.
Just a little change, small to say the least.